Good morning. Good morning. It is Friday, October 21st, 2022. Good morning. Good morning. And I hope you have your coffee with you. I have my Tim's. Yes. Good morning, Amy. So glad to see you this morning. And so this morning, as the sun comes up, I'm actually heading to my mom's. She's turning 82 today. And so I'm going to head down, have some lunch with her, and then come back for some things this evening. And yeah, so we're sitting in the en route on the 400. And so, good morning, Donna. And so one of the things, I like breakfast, right? So I needed to pack myself a breakfast, but I thought, why don't we just stop for something? Good morning, Karen. And I was like, oh, but my favorite breakfast when I go out is McDonald's. It just is. I like the egg McMuffin with bacon. And I like the orange juice at McDonald's, and I like the hash browns, right? That's why I would go to McDonald's. Good morning, Rob. Are the hash browns. And I've gone to Tim Hortons before, and I've had a hash brown from Tim Hortons, and I'm like, ew, that's gross. And so as I'm paddling this morning, I'm trying to figure out, okay, where are you going to stop for breakfast? Because you want to get as far. I have an appointment in Kingston at 10:30. I know, right? And so I'm like, I'm doing all the math in my head, and how far down the road can I get before morning Devos? And I'm like, oh, but there's no McDonald's on the way. And then I'm like, okay, you're going to try something new. There's a Wendy's. And so I get in my car and I get to the en route and I'm like, there's no Wendy's here. Oh, my heart was so sad. Because I pulled around and I'm like, I don't want a bagel. Okay, I'll just do Tim Hortons and I'll try the breakfast stuff at Tim Hortons again. Like, coffee is okay. My preferred coffee really is, I think, the one from Starbucks, but I'll drink Tim Hortons. And so I pull up and I said, okay, I'll try something new. The maple bacon breakfast sandwich. And so I'm like, okay, I'll try it. And then in my bag came a hash brown. I was like, oh, I'll try it. And so I pulled it out, and as you can see, I've tried it. There it is. And I was like, oh, this is actually quite good. This is much better than I thought it was. Than I remember it to be, right? And it got me thinking about what I was teaching about last night. So last night was our first night of How to Share Your Faith class, and it was so good. I got to hang out with 11 people. We did it in the 115 at the church, and we did it online. So if you're watching and you're thinking, oh, I'd really like to take that class, message me. I'll send you the link. You can join us next Thursday. Evening online, and there was good discussion online. Carolyn joined us and got to meet some of our church people, so that was fun. And one of the things that we talked about was preparation. And if we want to learn how to share our faith effectively, we have to prepare. And Billy Graham would say, if you want to have a good revival, there's three things that you need. So Billy Graham was an evangelist in both the 20th and 21st century, led through his ministry millions and millions of people to the Lord. And he would say, if you want to be effective, if you want to have a good revival, you need three things. First thing, pray. Make sure you pray. Second thing, pray. Third thing, pray. You need to pray. And the reason why you pray is because you have to invite God into the situation. You want to be in line with God, in step with God. There's this wonderful mystery in prayer that when we go to the Lord and we pray, it unlocks the supernatural into the natural. So we need to pray. We have all of our natural ideas, but we need to invite the supernatural God into the ideas to actually make them work. So Billy Graham would say, you have to pray. And I've been at Billy Graham crusades, and I've listened to him preach, and I was like, that's okay. And then he would make the call, and I would watch people flood forward, and I'd be like, wow. He would say, it's because people are praying. So we spent a lot of time last night talking about prayer and the importance of prayer. And every day, what do I ask you to do or tell you to do? I don't ask you, I tell you. Every day, what do I tell you to do? This is, I know it's Friday, right? So you can reflect back to me a little bit. Every day, I tell you to do something. So you can tell me what that is. And I also got my orange juice, which I so love from Tim Hortons. What is it that I tell you to do every single day? Good morning, Leanne. It's good to see you. Yeah, and Elizabeth, nice to see you too. Paul and Sue. Mm-hmm. Every day, what do I tell you to do? Every single day. Yep. Yeah, and so for those of you that this is the first time that you're watching, you're going to learn what I'm going to tell you to do every single day. Yep. What is it that I ask you to do every single day? Yep. Damn it, even. Go outside and help your community experience Christ. Yes. Go outside. Right? Go outside. Like, share, go outside and help your community experience Christ. You're so good. You know this. You know, this is what I ask you to do. I tell you to do it. Good morning, Jay. I hope you're enjoying your Dominican coffee. I know, and you're on vacation. Every day, go outside and help your community experience Christ. Okay, so I'm gonna tell you that in order to be effective in helping your community experience Christ, you gotta pray. You gotta pray. You gotta pray. And just like my hash brown tasted different today, I don't know what it is. Maybe I just don't have a good memory of it. Maybe for you, you're like, but prayer is just so boring, or I don't feel anything. I want to encourage you to try it. Give it a try for 1 week. I'm going to ask you to pray for 9 minutes every day. You're like, 9 minutes? I know, right? 9 minutes every day. You're going to pray for three things. Because we are called to impact our community for Christ. And if we want to, we can't do it in our own strength. We need to invite the supernatural God to be in our natural selves, right? To go before. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to pray for yourself. You're going to pray for yourself, Lord, that you would give me a passion and a desire to help my community to experience you. So 3 minutes, set your timer, 3 minutes. 3 minutes. Lord, give me a passion and a desire. You can even confess, I am tired and lazy. I might even be afraid. But would you help me? The verse that we looked at last evening was from Deuteronomy, where the Lord is telling Joshua to go into the land. And he says to him, be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or terrified because of them. For the Lord your God goes with you. He will never leave you or forsake you. So that's Deuteronomy 32:8, I think. So you're going to pray for yourself. 3 minutes to pray for yourself and maybe what your own hang-ups are about helping your community experience Christ. And you're like, oh, I can't do that with the Lord. I can't tell him why I don't want to go. Yes, you can. That's where he's going to start to change your heart. And you're like, I don't want my heart to be changed. 3 minutes. You would be surprised that when you start being honest with the Lord in this area, I'm afraid, I don't like talking to people who are different than I am, who speak differently than I am, that look differently than I am. When you start giving that to the Lord and say, God, I know this isn't right, or I don't even care that this is right. Like, just be honest. He'll start to change your heart. He'll start to change your heart. So pray for yourself. Pray for yourself. 3 minutes. You'd be surprised how fast 3 minutes goes. Second thing. pray for others. Pray for your neighbors. Pray for the people that are close to you. So for me, it's my neighbors. For you, be your family, right? Pray for opportunities. If you have loved ones who don't know the Lord, or even for your loved ones, that they too would experience the power of God, right? Because that pours into their story. My light turned off. There we go. So pray for others. So pray for your family. I pray for my neighbors. I actually have their names on my fridge. And so be praying for your neighbors. Be praying that God would draw them close to Him. God would draw them close to Him. Secondly, that He would open the eyes of their heart, of their minds. It says that the enemy of this world has blinded them to the things of the Lord. So be praying that God would draw them to Himself, that He would take off the blinders, that I'm going to say godly people would find their way into their lives, right? Because it might not be you who talks to your neighbor, but you can be praying that other people are motivated to talk to your neighbor. Because God might use you to talk to somebody else's neighbor. Because that's what He does. So 3 minutes. 3 minutes for yourself, your own issues about helping others experience Christ. Secondly, pray for others that God would draw them near, take the blinders off their eyes, and that godly people would find their way into their lives and speak into their lives, being their friend. Third thing, pray for opportunities and delivery. This passage from Colossians that we looked at last night was so good. Devote yourselves to prayer. This is Colossians 4, 2-4. Devote yourself to prayer, being watchful and thankful, and pray for us too, that God may open a door for our message so that we may proclaim the mystery of Christ, for which I am in chains. Pray that I may proclaim it clearly and as I should. So we can be praying for opportunities, and that we would share Jesus with others the way that we should, with clarity, that we would know how to turn conversations. Ask Jesus to help you to turn conversations, and you will be surprised what He does. So pray for 3 minutes. 3 minutes, 3 minutes for yourself, 3 minutes for others, and 3 minutes for opportunities, that you would say the right things at the right time, turning conversations, and that God would just move, right? Try something new. I didn't think this little hash brown would be any good. And I tried it, and I was like, oh, that's so good. When you start praying and asking God to change your heart, changing the hearts of the people around you, praying for opportunities, you're going to be surprised at what God is doing. He's going to start to change the way that you think. He's going to start to change the way that you feel. He's going to start to change the way that you talk. And you're going to be amazed at what God's going to do because you went to Him in prayer. If we want to successfully help our community experience Christ, we need to pray. So let's do it. Lord God, we want our community experience Christ wherever we are, whether we're in the GBA or in the GTA, or whether we're in Kingston or in England or in the US or wherever we might be watching today. Lord God, we want your kingdom to come. And you have entrusted us with a mission of going and telling everyone about you, because you want to be with everyone, and you choose us as your vessels to tell other people, which is just so crazy. Us who have so many excuses of why we can't go, our fears, our insecurities. And so, Father, would you meet with us today? Would you help us to be strong and courageous, not terrified or discouraged? Help us not to be afraid of other people. Lord, we pray for our loved ones, our co-workers, our friends, our neighbors, the people at the grocery store in Tim Hortons. May we be light and life and joy and truth to them today. Help us to be generous in our time with others, that they might know that you love them. And Lord, help us to return all the glory to you. We pray this in your name. Amen. Amen. All right, my dear friends. That's it. That's all. I hope you have a great, great day. Remember to like, share, go outside, and go help your community experience Christ. Pray first. 9 minutes for yourself, for others, and opportunities. Okay, bye.